Thank you. Andrew Davis conducted the BBC Symphony Orchestra in that Proms Premiere of the Elgar Payne Symphony No. 3. And Andrew Davis and the BBC Symphony Orchestra on its feet, accepting the acclaim of the packed shirt-sleeved audience in the Royal Albert Hall after that performance. He said in the interview we heard and saw earlier that he couldn't tell at first where Elgar finished and where Anthony Payne began, although he, of course, knows now. So great was the meeting of minds and inspirations in the score which we've heard tonight. And Andrew Davis is now gesturing to Tony Payne himself, who has revealed, incidentally, that that little tam-tam at the end in the timpani is his own signature. Indeed, the end was a problem for him. What would Elgar have done, he thought, as he comes to the front and embraces Andrew Davis. They've been here before, of course, that memorable premiere at the Royal Festival Hall earlier this year. But a wonderful performance tonight, which is greeted with huge cheers as Tony Payne himself bows to the Albert Hall, shakes hands with the orchestra, which has done so much, the orchestra, BBC Symphony Orchestra, to make this third symphony come alive, utterly committed to its performance and a great belief in it. Of course, a fantastic labour of love for Tony Payne, who was first gripped by these sketches, 130 pages of them, more than 25 years ago. And he discovered when he wrote the last bar that by chance it fell on Elgar, the 60th anniversary of Elgar's death, something which came as quite a surprise and quite a moving moment for him. Of course, the problem that Tony Payne then had was to get Elgar, in a sense, out of his head and get back to writing his own music. He did feel that it was imperative, after finishing this great work which had taken so long and occupied his mind and his spirit for so long, to get back to his own music. And he did so. He said he'd been living inside Elgar's head for a couple of years, and he really wondered how easy it was to get back to his own music. But he's managed the transition. He said he was off soon writing a piano trio, as if nothing had intervened between it and his previous work. Although, of course, something enormous had intervened, the third symphony of Elgar, which we've heard tonight. And these great scenes bring us to the end of tonight's prom from the Royal Albert Hall. Tomorrow night, on Radio 3, you can hear a performance of Sir Harrison Burt Whistle's The Triumph of Time. That'll be followed by Beethoven's Choral Symphony, the 9th, performed by the City of Birmingham Symphony Orchestra and Chorus, conducted by Sir Simon Rattle. And our season of proms on BBC One is starting next Thursday, the 20th of August, at 10 to 11. There'll be four of them. You can hear a programme of Bernstein, Ravel and Gershwin, performed by the BBC Philharmonic Orchestra. It'll be conducted by Jan-Pascal Tortelier. But for now, from all of us here at an excited Royal Albert Hall, good night.